Education is the most decisive and strategic variable for accompanying and metabolizing any process of innovation and social transformation, not simply an instrument. About a fortnight ago, I participated also as a double AAS delegate in the UNESCO International Conference Paris, also to deliver our official invitation to the UNESCO General Directorate, where there was a lot of discussion about the future of education, a new social contract. This is the title of the new UNESCO Global Action and of an old scientific publication of mine. These are important signals, as you know. At last, we are starting to become aware and to act concretely, starting from the assumption that education, aware of the thin line between education and indoctrination, is not a simple tool able to accompany change and social transformation. Education, the quality, as you know, a complex concept of the education and training process, is the fundamental infrastructure of any process of innovation and change. Social and cultural factors are as important as economic factors, if not more so. So, education is citizenship, education is democracy, and democracy is complexity. The objective of this panel is to highlight the strategic relevance of educational process in rethinking and rebuilding a new global citizenship within a culture of responsibility, indispensable instrument for creating a truly democratic system. These complex instruments require long-term action necessary for constructing cultural change and a culture of prevention. Currently, the politics and the policies of the nation states, which have been thrown into a profound crisis by globalization, continue to fall back on short-term rationales and instruments. Social transformation, which will never be fully realized without centering it around the people, require systemic change, which must be a bottom-up, a grassroots process directly involving the quality of education and training. The time has come to begin questioning the persistent economistic paradigm, which continues to reinforce the hegemonic opinion, which I consider nearsighted and deceptive, that processes of change and transformation can be determined solely and exclusively by legal, technological, and economical factors, perpetrating a vision of society as a gigantic mechanism.